There are several ways to mix audio in Avid Media Composer. When you are working with audio, you may want to configure an audio workspace, which will make things easier when it comes to mixing audio tracks. First, let's edit a music track under the fire rescue sequence. Load the music clip into the source window. As soon as you do that, you will notice that the music clip has two tracks of audio, which means this clip is probably in stereo. The default setup for Media Composer is to have two video tracks and two audio tracks for a new sequence. To add a new audio track, right-click in this gray area of the timeline window and choose New Audio Track Mono. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Command U to add a new audio track. Now, remember, when using the red override function, make sure you tell Media Composer where you want your content to go. In this case, we want the music to go onto audio tracks 3 and 4. So in this example, I'll patch the source audio, A2 to A4, and A1 to A3. Also, it's important to turn off any additional sequence tracks. Otherwise, blank filler will be overwritten on top of them. The next step is to mark in and out points for an area where you would like the music to go. Now, when you have an entire section like this, it is easier to press the Mark Clip button to mark the entire area. You can also press the T key on the keyboard. Okay, now it's time to press the Override button, or the B key, so the music goes to tracks 3 and 4 within the sequence. Let's check it out.
We had a call from fire rescue that there were three men being extricated from a manhole, and all three of them were unconscious.
Came to find out they said there was possibly methane inside, they were doing work.
Now, you'll notice that the audio mix definitely needs some help. You may want to configure the interface so it is easier to adjust audio levels. First, navigate to the Windows menu and choose Workspaces, Audio Editing. This will automatically bring forward the audio mixer and the audio tool. Now you can change the workspace to your liking. So, for example, you may want a larger timeline area for the audio editing workspace. For Media Composer to remember the new window arrangement, navigate back to the Windows menu and choose Save Current. Now, once that's done, you may want to increase the size of the audio tracks. To resize a track individually, hold down the Alt key while dragging from the bottom of each track indicator. If you are running Media Composer on a PC, hold down the Control key. Next, navigate to the lower left corner of the timeline window and click on the Fast menu. Choose Audio Data, Clip Gain. This will show you volume unit indicators within the audio tracks. Now, once you have everything configured the way you like it, click on the Timeline View menu at the bottom of the timeline. Choose Save As and give it a name. This will make it easy to switch between different timeline views the next time you are ready to work with adjusting audio levels. Now, when you switch between workspaces, I recommend that you link your workspace with the correct timeline view. To do this, navigate to the Windows menu and select Workspaces, Properties. The Workspace View dialog box will appear. Click on the Link to Named Settings button. Now type in the exact name of the timeline view for audio editing. So now, assuming you have configured and linked the various workspace views, when you switch between workspaces, everything should be configured the way you like it. So now, when I go back to the audio editing workspace, the timeline view and interface windows will jump to their configured location. Okay, now you've got the basics of configuring workspaces and timeline views.